Okay, in last session, we have completed biotechnology part number 3. And in part number 3, we concluded there in gene therapy. We were going through the applications of biotechnology. In part 1, we have seen the definition of biotechnology, the meaning of biotechnology, the traditional biotechnology, modern biotechnology, and we have seen the biological tools of biotechnology, and so on. So informations we have seen there in part 1. And in part 2, we completed rDNA technology methodology of rDNA technology. This is what we have seen there in part 2. Part 2, that was completely dedicated for rDNA technology. Then we came to part 3. Part 3, that is talking about the application part of biotechnology. In application part of biotechnology, very first we have seen healthcare applications. Applications in the field of healthcare, that is medical field. And in your test book, there is one application that is given as A, that is healthcare. And after that, they have given B application as agriculture, but that agriculture part I didn't touch. And the C part, that is gene therapy. So that is also related with the health. And so what I did after A, healthcare, I mentioned the C part as B, that is healthcare, gene therapy. So on gene therapy, we completed. By that, one part we finished, that is part 3. Now we are going to the part 4. So in part 4, what we are going to see? So in part 4, we are going to see about plants, applications, then the field of plants. Or in plant biology, what applications the biotechnology is having. So there, I merged two things. In your test book, the application part B, that is agriculture. And there is another part that is called transgenic plants or genetically modified plants or GM plants. These two parts, I merged there in this part. So in this part, we are going to talk about application there in the field of plants or in the field of agriculture. So now let us see. Voice is not there. I'm not audible. Not audible. Audible, no? So Jan, I think you have some problem there in your connectivity over there. Okay, because I got a message that not audible, no voice at all. So we were talking about the application of biotechnology in the field of agriculture. Now let us see one after the other. Now let us see. This is the previous slide introduction part. Actually, we have to cover up 4 various areas. Okay, application, applied sectors. This all we have seen there in the previous slide. That is just a repetition because this is application of biotechnology. So this slide I kept like that. Daniel, it is your problem. I think your connectivity problem is there. I mean, you just check with your device because other members are writing that it's audible for them. So for them, it's quite okay. Maybe your connectivity problem, maybe your device audible part means that maybe disconnected or something is there. You just observe there. Check with your device. Okay. If you are not getting the voice again, no, you just rejoin. Okay. Just log out and log in. Not log in. You just go to your WhatsApp group and then again join. So it will become okay then. Okay. So this whole part we have seen there in the previous slides. Since it's the application part, we are not going to repeat that part. Now, today's session, we are going to talk about application of biotechnology there in the field of agriculture. Now, in the field of agriculture, you can see that two applications basically we can have two what you can say applications we can say. One is that the application of biotechnology in a scientific manner. That means scientific technique we can apply there in the field of agriculture. That means what is this scientific technique? In your test book, some mistake, I don't know that it is a mistake or not. So they have written that scientific techniques like that. If I check, no, what is written that the scientific techniques such as. But you see, not such as over there. Because of scientific techniques, you are getting certain results. And that is what is written over there. So what those results, we can say, the result of scientific technique, what is that? One, you are able to produce genetically modified organisms. The first technique, I mean, application of biotechnology through scientific techniques is that you are able to produce genetically modified organisms. Genetically modified organisms. Now I will do again, Janvi is repeating the same thing only. You just see your voice button, if it is mute or not, something you just check there. Because since everybody getting my voice, then I hope even let me see my device, second device. Hello, my check. Yeah, it's getting over there. Okay. Okay, so the first thing is that you are able to develop, yeah, produce genetically modified organisms through certain scientific techniques. Now, what do you mean by this genetically modified organisms? This in short form, we call them as GM plants or GMOs. Now, here we are talking about not only plants, we are talking about the entire living organisms, say plants and animals. That is why in the picture also, you have seen multiple items. When plants item there, animal item is also there. Okay, so genetically modified organisms you can develop by means of scientific technology which are used there in biotechnology. So that is one point. And here if you observe, you can see that many different types of plants today available which are genetically modified. Not only plants, even animals also. You can see the fish is there, chicken is there, or even pigs there, cow there, sheep there. So like that, various types of animals. If you talk about plants, you see various types of plants, you can see here itself. The plant products you see, you observe over here itself. Like apple is there, corn is there, cotton there, then oil producing plants are there, papaya there, potato there, tomato there, beetroot there, yeast. So many different types of organisms available today which are genetically modified, but this modification could be done by following certain scientific techniques which are part and parcel of biotechnology. Okay, I hope that this first point you understood, that is, it involves scientific technique, thereby we could produce genetically modified organisms. Okay, now point number two is that when specifying over here BT cottons. Now, there are so many plants which are called BT. The reason why we call it as BT, that is called in this particular plant, whether it is BT cotton or any other plant, if it is writing with the BT, that is called Bacillus thuringiensis. You know that Bacillus thuringiensis is, what you can say, is a bacterium. And it's producing a spore. And that is serving certain important role over here. So what is happening here in these plants? That particular gene available there in the bacteria is introduced. So the bacterial gene means the gene from bacteria, I mean Bacterium bacillus thuringiensis, have been inserted into this plant. And that gene, earlier it was a part of the bacterium, but now it is a part and parcel of this plant. So BT cotton you are getting, and this is produced scientifically only. So scientific, by following scientific technique. Then another one we can notice that we could produce plants. So many different types of plants we could produce. They are having the resisting power against what you can say certain pest. So you see, if you look at maize and so on, so plants, you can say this kind of worms attacking them, and you see that plant become useless and there is no productivity. So this kind of pest we can control today by developing what you can say this kind of plants. And this plant we can say that is pest resistant. This kind of worms, this kind of what you can say, any kind of pest or insect or whatever it is, cannot attack those plants. So the pest resistant plants we could develop scientifically by following the biotechnology principles. Now you see, in short, what we can say, by following the scientific technique as a part of application of biotechnology, today we can say that we could modify plants, we could modify animals and microorganisms. But for what purpose you are modifying them? What is the purpose of modifying these plants, animals and microbes? The purpose is that improve the quality as well as quantity. Improve the quality as well as quantity. Everybody getting my voice? So Janva is facing the same issue still, and she is asking me, please reply me, sir, what I will say. You unmute yourself and talk. Janva, you do one thing, you unmute yourself and talk. Because on my screen now, your picture is not there. Your screen, I cannot see because I'm sharing my screen right now. So if you're talking, then I can say I am audible. If you are not talking, okay. Janva, let me see. Another thing is that you have not written your name proper manner. I'm not hearing you. You unmute yourself. Check your device or log out and then log in. Okay, I send the message. Okay, so what is the purpose of modifying plants and animals? The purpose is that, one, to improve the quality of the plants or animals, as well as improve the quantity. Quality means various characteristics it have. That means even you can see that all these genetic disease resistant plants, pest resistant plants. So this all we can say and quality. And another thing we can notice that when the quality of nutrients, regarding nutrients, when we improve the nutrients, there also we can say the quality increases. Then another thing is that quantity increases. Quantity means the productivity. So the reason for modifying the plants, one, improve their quality, and second, improve the quantity. Okay. Now you see that various techniques. I mean, number one, you have seen that one, you are following scientific technique. Scientific technique means the rDNA technology, that is the most important technology. That is why we are genetically modifying the plants. The genes are altered. So in scientific technique, we are following rDNA technology. Now there is another technique involved over here. This is what is called tissue culture. Now you look at the picture over here, you can see that in the petri dish, you see there is a group of cells. And this group of cells, you can say it is formed. That this we can say as a callus. And this callus is formed from either a single cell or a tissue or an organ from a plant. You take a single leaf, you take a small central cambium region of the carrot, or you take an organ like anther, or you take a pollen grain, or anything you take and transfer into a medium, that is nutrient medium. And from the nutrient medium, the cell will absorb the nutrients and it will start dividing. The cell will divide one after the other. So when the cell divides, the division will go on continuously. And as a result, you get a mass of cells like this. And this mass of cells, which are unorganized, we can call as callus. And to this callus, if you are providing the shoot producing hormone, the root producing hormone, that means, you know, you can see that the cytokine is there, yeah, even the auxin is there. So whatever hormone you are providing over here, accordingly, you see the picture over here in the test tube, you see slowly and slowly the shoot is developed. First shoot is developed and then root is developed. Now this is what you can see over here. Now you see the shoot is developing one after the other. And once the shoot is developed, you can see that the root, you are providing the root producing hormone and then you can develop the root. So once the shoot and root is developed there in the test tube, you are getting an entire plant. So this is what the application part of tissue culture. Okay. And tissue culture, we can notice that the most important role today's world is that micropropagation. Micropropagation means, you see, you can produce, now you just look at over here. In the picture, you can see that there are so many plants and so many bottles. All these plants, we can say, that is developed by means of tissue culture. That I mean, if there is a single cell and that cell is repeatedly divides, say 1,000 cells formed, and these 1,000 cells can develop into 1,000 plants. You see, one single cell you have taken from a leaf, you are from a plant, that is transferred into a culture medium, and that single cell divides, you get ultimately a group of unorganized mass of cells. I said, what do you call this unorganized mass of cells? Please write them in the chat box. Earlier I said the name of that. The previous picture I told you, when the cell divides repeatedly, you get a group of cells which are unorganized. And this cell is, that unorganized mass of cell is having a name. What is the name? I don't think that is not there in your textbook, I think. You remember? I'm waiting for your response. Yes. So what is the name I said? Don't remember? Okay. I cannot wait for a long time because from your end, the response is not coming. So last time also I stopped asking questions because of this no response from your end. Okay. So you can see that a group of cells form which are unorganized, and this unorganized mass of cells is called callus. Callus, C-A-L-L-U-S. That is called callus. Okay. Unorganized mass of cells. And this callus, we can see that can develop into an entire plant when you are providing the hormones. But you see, you want to develop thousands of plants, then what to do there? Break the callus. Again, you culture them in a medium. So you can get so many callus. And when you provide the hormone for shoot and root, you set these kind of plants. And these plants, if you look at genetically, all these plants are what do you feel? Genetically, all these plants are different or same? Please write there in the chat box your response. Same. So genetically, all these plants are same. So if genetically the plants are same, what technical term we are using, you know? What is the technical term we are using to call a plant, a group of plants which are genetically same? No? Not homo? Something else? Some technical term is there? Yes, very good. Rashmi has given me the answer. The answer is the clone. So that is called as clone. Okay? So you can see that all these plants are clones because they are genetically similar. They are genetically identical. And all these plants are genetically same, genetically similar, and developed from a common cell. And so all these plants, we can say clones. At the same time, we can say this technology, this methodology for developing large number of plants, genetically same plants, genetically similar plants, within a short period of time, within a limited area, by using a single cell or group of cells, we can say as micropropagation. That is called micropropagation. You want n number of plants you can develop by tissue culture in your lab within a short period of time. So this is what is called a micropropagation. Now look at the next picture over here. See, in all these plastic bottles, what do you see? There are different types of plants. Now you see here in this, you can see the plants are developing roots, shoot. If you closely observe each and every beaker, the plastic bottles which are there in the lab, you can see that leaves are seen. That means they are developing into plants. You see, in a small area, in a small rack, there are rack, we can say. The small rack, you see how many plants are kept. In a normal procedure, you cannot do it. Normal procedure, can you do it? You can develop so many plants like this, and so you can keep these plants one above the other like this. You cannot. So in biotechnology, the tissue culture, another important role, there another important area, there biotechnology is having an important role. Now you see, all these things are nothing, they are germplasm. This is a germplasm that you can store there in a lab. You can store in a lab like this, in a small glass where you can store it for a long time. So these are the tissue culture areas. Micropropagation, that is the most important point to be remembered. And this we can say, that is the large scale production of plants which are genetically same. At the same time, it helps us to store germplasm. And we are able to maintain clones. Clones you already know. Okay. And another important area where it is having an important role, that is given in your test books, in the box only, I think. So this technology, we can use there in recalcitrant seed producing plants. Recalcitrant seed producing plants means, see, recalcitrant seed means, you see, if you are keeping seeds at home, if you are storing seeds at home, you cannot store these seeds for such a long time. Because when you store these seeds, now you see here papaya seeds are there, when the watermelon seeds are there, even the avocado is there, and even rubber plant seeds are there. So many seeds you can see over here. But these seeds, if you keep at home, if you are storing, you can see that the moisture content of the seed, the level will go down slowly and slowly. Whatever moisture content is there, and that will slow down. That will go down. And that will go down, and after a period of time, there is a particular shelf life. After that, these seeds, we can notice that this become useless, because these seeds will not become viable then. Viable means it will not germinate. because you know that seeds are used for vegetative propagation, for multiplication purpose, for getting new plants. And if you are sowing these seeds there in the soil, you won't get a new plant because the viability of the seed is lost because of storing. And such type of seeds we call as recalcitrant seeds. So in that case, how will you develop the plants? How will you multiply the plants? Because seeds are producing that problem. Because even you know that in papaya also, you know that the seeds are not functional like that. So in such case, if you want to multiply the plants, the best idea is that go for tissue culture. Instead of depending on seeds, you can go for tissue culture plants. Okay, that means that is modified plant. So then that recalcitrant seed issue will not come up. So these are the various areas the tissue culture is functioning. Now we can see that our point is that in agriculture, biotechnology is having an important role. Before we go into this topic, we will go for a poll. So get ready for a poll now. Okay. Because I did not remove the questions which are already done. So I have to check the questions. We'll go for 16. Okay, I'm launching one question. This is a multiple choice question, not only one answer. So you can answer, everybody can answer two questions. Yeah, I mean two, yeah, three, yeah, four answers. Okay, the time is over. We are going to stop it. Okay, fine. Only half people have answered. 51% of people answered this question. That is why these days now your response is, I don't know what happened. This showing any poll in my device. That is an issue with the device. Maybe the problem with the device, because it will be shown everywhere. Once your device is okay, it will be shown everywhere. Now let me see the answer. Now this is a multiple choice question. You have to see the bracket if it is written after the question. You can see the bracket, they will write multiple choice. Multiple choice means this question is having more than one answer, more than one option. That is the point. That means you can mark one answer and after that you can mark again. But mostly, yeah, if this bracket is not there, that means that you can mark only once. Once you marked one answer, then if you go to another answer to mark, then the first one will be removed. But in this case, it's not like that. So multiple choice question, always you have to be careful while giving the answer. Now, what is the question? Which is the cloning organism used in plant biotechnology? Which is the cloning organism used in plant biotechnology? What is the answer? In short form, you can use the chat box and write. In short form, you write. No answer? Yes, I got one answer, E. coli. Agrobacterium tumefaciens, very good. The person who has written knows that who has written that. I'm not saying the name over here. Now it's good. Okay. You cannot see an answer. What happened, Vinayak? What is wrong with the device today? Your device? Okay. So here, now you see, what is the cloning organism used in plant biotechnology? Four options are there. One is called Escherichia coli. Second is that Agrobacterium tumescens. Third, Escherichia coli. Then fourth is Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Now you see, from this itself, from the answer itself, you can say something related. One, Escherichia. Second is Agrobacterium. But only thing you have to see that written in a wrong manner. Okay, in a confusing manner, the answer is, the options are given over there. So you should know the name correctly and spelling also. Now here, first look at the Escherichia coli is one answer, that is absolutely correct. Second is that Agrobacterium tumefaciens. So, but option, look at their first option we have written, Escherichia coli, coil, Escherichia coil, spelling mistake. Okay, you can easily find out what is the spelling over there. Second one, look at their Agrobacterium tumescens, faciens not there, Agrobacterium tumescens. Okay. Third one, look at their Escherichia coli, that is properly written. And the fourth one, Agrobacterium tumefaciens, that also properly written. Okay. So those who have written that pairing correctly, that means only 60% of people have given the answer. Only 51% of students answered it. And 60% they opted for Escherichia coli and Agrobacterium. That means third and fourth done correctly. And 27% and 53%. That means everybody did not answer properly. So there we can see that they have written the A and B. A and B is absolutely wrong. The correct answers are C and D. Is it clear to you now? Now it's okay, friends. Okay. Now I'm going for another poll. Okay, I will give you one more poll. Just look at this poll. Come on, tell me the answer. You, McVish, you do one thing. You update your device, I think. Update in the sense, no? It must be updated. Updated means every now and then the Zoom is updating their system. Every now and then they are updating their system. So you also have to update the system. Automatically it has to be updated. So then it is okay. Some problem you have. That is fine. Okay, 46. Come on quickly. Even now 50%, 53%. Now 8 seconds baki hai. 8 seconds, 5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3, 2, 1, time over. Okay. Now the result is there on your screen. Okay, here the question. The question, look at there, the transfer of rDNA into bacterial cell is assisted by, that means the chimeric DNA you have to transfer to the competent host. And for that, we can notice that you need some support. And here the options given, that is magnesium plus plus, manganese plus plus, calcium plus plus, and cadmium plus plus. Yeah, I got some answer over there. That is absolutely correct, Aryan. And here, 47% is saying that magnesium plus plus or magnesium. Is it correct, friends? Please use the chat box. Yeah, people are saying no. Then what is the correct answer? Those who are reading the test book, they can give the answer correctly. If you are not reading your test book regularly, then it may be difficult for you to answer. Please remember, I repeat, this year's exam, even nowadays, you know that MCQs and one mark question, they are giving due importance, because it is at par with the All India now. So many objective type questions are there. In objective type MCQ, 10 MCQs are there. I think you got the question pattern yesterday. That is not yours. Yours means for you also the same only. But the weightage which is given, that may be different for you, because test book chapters, some kind of alteration has been done for certain chapters. For biotechnology, whatever weightage is given, that full weightage will be there. But what I want to say, that MCQ, if you look at, that MCQ mark is enough for you to get passing mark there in biology. This is the reason why I say always, always that biology, as far as biology is concerned, to get a first class, it's so easy. Little bit if you work, you can get a second class. But at the same time, it's so difficult to get a passing mark. When I'm repeating the same thing before you also, every year I'm saying this point. So easy to get a first class mark. First class mark, if I say, that is 60 plus out of 100. 50 plus second class. But just passing mark, third class, 35 marks, is not so easy. Even if you observe last year's result, you can see that the number of students who got third class, they are just passed. Comparing with the second class and first class of even distinctions of other students, you see that is very less. So why I'm saying this one, if you read your test book and if you're giving due importance to your MCQs and one mark question, MCQs, 10 questions are there. One mark questions are, I think, eight questions or something. One mark. One mark means one word answer. One word, yeah, one sentence answer. This same question, what I have given there on the screen right now, I can give this question as one mark question or even MCQ type question. Okay. So some 15, 18 marks you are getting over there. And practical, you just see 30 marks. Your journal and project and Viva carries 10 marks. Activities carrying, even there also a spotted site. Earlier it was 6 only, now it is 10. I think 10 spots are there now. 10 spots, just imagine. 10 spots, easily you can score 10 marks. Only 5 marks questions will be there for, 10 marks question for activity. so easy to score the mark because today's examination system is made in such a way, it's so easy compared to our time. The intention of the teachers or the government or even the board or everybody's intention is that students should get the mark. That is what. So my point is that you have to read your test book. Otherwise, you cannot give the answer. And moreover, you have to give more importance to MCQs and one mark question. Why? The reason is that. Now you see that the Bombay, I mean, all the universities of Maharashtra is going to conduct their final year exam in a MCQ format. I'm asking one question to you, friends. If your examination is conducted in an MCQ manner, do you like it? Please use the chat box. Do you like, you will approve, you will accept if they are giving the entire examination of your final exam is in an MCQ format? You will accept. Okay. All of you are writing that yes, yes, yes. But there is a disadvantage in it. Why you are saying that you will accept it? What is the reason? What is the reason? Any reason that you are saying that MCQs you like? You are not saying the reason, but I can say you are thinking that no need to read the test book, no need to write in lengthy, no need to, what you can say, but it is not possible. It may be, but the reason is that, okay, you are saying that is okay, but you see now yesterday's paper, if you read, you can see that the students of Maharashtra is objecting. The Maharashtra students are objecting for this MCQ type examination. They said the reason also, that is a genuine reason. What they said, that is absolutely correct. What they said, you know, MCQ test we don't want because if one answer that is wrong, we will lose 100% a mark. If it is a answer writing type question, even if something wrong, we will get something as a mark. You got the point what I said? If it is MCQ, that is a disadvantage. If it is MCQ, the answer is wrong means that is wrong. You will not get any mark out of it. You have one mark. If it is one mark, that one mark has gone. But if it is an answering type question, lengthy type question, yeah, sentence making question, yeah, paragraph making question, what they say, that is absolutely correct. So even if it is one mark question, if the answer is wrong, they may get half mark. That is what they said. That is different thing. Knowledge matter is different thing. But examination I'm talking. So the reason is that in MCQ question, disadvantage is that if the answer is less, just like mathematics. In mathematics, you see you are writing the whole page over there and ultimately you are getting the answer, but anywhere the step is wrong, the final you are losing the entire mark. Same manner in case of MCQ also. If answer is right, you get full credit. If the answer is wrong, you are losing full. There is no full credit there. There is not even a partial credit also. Fully wrong, fully gone. So what to do for that? What is the solution for that? The solution is that read your test book and understand the concept. You have to keep on reading the test book and understand the concept. Then only you can answer MCQ type questions correctly. Otherwise, कुछ लोग जो entrance exam को करते हैं ना, first question A दिया तो दूसरा B, A B C D, नहीं तो पूरा question का एक ही option C C C C C, 50 question है 50 question C C C mark किया तो उसमें से कुछ ना कुछ correct होगा करके सोच के answer देता है. So this kind of what you can say manipulations there among the students. So remember, so in your examinations also, sometimes chances are there like that. So be very careful. Even as already in the test book, that type of question is there. One mark type question is there. One word type question is there. So if you are not able to give the answer correctly, you may lose the mark. So here, the answer is calcium. Okay, what is that? Plus plus. Okay, divalent. Okay, calcium, not magnesium. Here, majority said magnesium. Where you see magnesium, can you tell me? Mg. Correct answer is C, number three. Yes, exactly, Rashmi. So in PCR, we are using Mg. Okay, so this is all about this. We will go to the topic now. We'll go to the topic. Okay, now we are going to see that how we are able to develop genetically modified organism. Now you see, when we do agriculturing, even if you know, you may be knowing that in today's present, I mean in present scenario, because of the lockdown and all, you know that our GDP has gone into a negative, gone into negative. Now our GDP is negative. Everywhere we can notice that it is somewhat there in a paralyzed manner, except one area, that is agriculture. In agriculture, you can see that the growth is positive, but in all other areas, it is negative. That is why our GDP is negative. That means our economy is going to decline. But as far as agriculture is concerned, it is positive. Now, when you do farming, when you go for agriculturing, what is your intention? Your intention, your purpose of cultivation of plants, we can say, that is just increase or get food production, productivity. Food productivity, that is the main objective of agriculture. And this food production, we can increase by three methods. Three methods are there in front of us. The first is written that agrochemical based agriculture. What does it mean, friends? Please write there in the chat box. What do you mean by agrochemical based agriculture? What do you mean by it? If you didn't understand, well, I will repeat this point. You see, agriculture, that means we can say that Indians, we can say majority of them are farmers. And agriculturing, so their important purpose of agriculture is that get more product, I mean food production, produce food. That is the most important idea. And how to increase the productivity, that is our question. Now you just imagine that when you are going to college, you are going to classes also, am I right? Why are you going to classes, friends? You want to bunk the lecture of the college, that is why. Or you want to teach the teachers, that is why. Or you want to neglect the college, that is why. Why are you going to classes? Coaching classes I'm talking about. Yeah, tuitions I'm talking about. Why are you going to tuition centers? Yeah, coaching classes. Why are you going? Nobody is there here. On karke rakhe chale gaya. Extra studies. That means you want to learn something more. So whatever you are learning from here, you want to improve yourself, or for improving purpose you are going. Same manner, in agriculture, we have three options for increasing the production. Plants cannot go to coaching class to improve. So here the improve means food productivity. That is improved by three methods. One is that agrochemical based agriculture. What is that? What do you mean by it? Agrochemical based agriculture. No. Yeah, that can be added. That can be said. Okay. Agrochemical based agriculture means using chemical fertilizer. Why do you use fertilizer there in the soil? To increase the productivity. Am I right? So we are, even if you go to farmers, agriculture land, we can say people are adding fertilizer there in the soil. Why are they adding fertilizer in the soil? If there is any nutrients, missing there, or even shortfall is there, and that can be corrected there. That means ultimate purpose is that better yield. Better yield. Okay, plants growing better means you are getting better yield. So chemical fertilizers are used there. Yeah, urea used there, ammonia used there, phosphate used there, NPK fertilizers are used there. That is agrochemical based fertilizer, agriculture. Second agriculture is that organic agriculture. What is this organic agriculture? Organic agriculture means we are not using chemical fertilizer, we are using biofertilizers. Biofertilizers, yeah, biological fertilizers. Okay, biofertilizers, vermicompost, manure. So manure is there, farmyard manure is there. So different types of compost there. So when we are using non-chemical fertilizers, like biofertilizers or biological fertilizers, we say that is organic agriculture. But in today's world, the most advanced one is that we are going for genetically engineered crop-based agriculture. What is that? What is said there? Genetically engineered crop-based agriculture. That is, genetically engineered means we are modifying their genome. In our DNA technology, what we have learned that we are applying over here in agriculture. That is genetically engineered crop-based agriculture. As a result of this, as a result of genetically engineering or genetic engineering, we get the plants which are genetically modified. And this genetically modified organisms, we say GMOs, and they're the plants. They can be the bacteria, they can be fungus, the various animals, and all these, the plants, animals, fungus, or bacteria, that we can, otherwise we can say microbes. And all these organisms, genes can be altered by manipulation. This is what is called rDNA technology. Okay? This is what is called rDNA technology. So in rDNA technology, we are modifying the genetic constitution of the plants, and that will help us to improve the quality as well as the quantity. Or it can improve the quality of the food, or it can improve the quantity of the food production. Okay. So today we are going to see about the genetically modified organisms, because the chemical fertilizers are out that we are not using today, and we are minimizing it. And minimize means we are not encouraging that. We are not encouraging the use of chemical fertilizers. We are encouraging the biofertilizers, organic agriculture we are encouraging today. And biofertilizers and biological fertilizers we are encouraging today. And GM plants, scientifically it is there, but always some ethical issues there. So we can say that some kind of dispute there regarding the genetically modified plants. But still, we could develop many plants which are genetically altered, genetically modified. Okay? So, in next section, actually, we have to study about these genetically modified plants. Okay, I don't want to continue this topic now itself. That we will see tomorrow. And today's session, we have seen the application part there in the agriculture. And tomorrow, we will talk about the genetically modified organisms. Okay, that means the GMOs and even the transgenic plants. So this we will start from tomorrow. Okay, I hope that you are following me. You are quite okay. My voice, I don't know how much it is audible over there. So tomorrow we will see. But before we leave today, I want to say a little bit about the practical part. Practical session, journal, everything I want to say a little bit. And after that, I will leave you. Okay. I'll change this screen. Now I'll go for revise the syllabus. I will show you the revise the syllabus first. Now, friends, you see, I have posted e-copy of your practical handbook. I think you got it. Got it or not? Yes. And what about the handbook? You got it? Handbook, you got the one? Yeah, yes, you got it. So now what I want to say, one second. So now here, the practical session, look at there. This is the practical session for you, right? Are you able to see that on the screen right now, friends?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you see there, you have four experiments over there. I'm not going to say anything about in detail right now. I will just show you important thing. You go to page number 10, what I'm showing over here. There you see some ABCD is written. Let me take a laser. Now you see, this is A. Okay, in A, you have to do two experiments there. One is floral display. And second is that DNA isolation. Floral display, even I can show you over here also. But right now, I'm not doing anything with the experiment number A. That we will see later. Let us see whether it is whether the Cora is going to open on January 1st. Let us see. Okay, we are not sure anything about it now. As on today, I just heard that maybe January 1st. So if it is January 1st, then all the practicals we have to do online over there. Then let us see. But experiment number A, I'm not going to say anything about right now. B, that also we are not going to do it now. C, that also we are not going to do now. Now come to directly to D. In D part, you look at there. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 is there, na? A, B, C, D, 4. Yeah. 10 questions are there. Sport, you have 10 questions A to J. Okay, so A to J is there, and in that A, B, C, D is written, and they have given that A mein kya aane wala hai, B mein kya aane wala hai, wo sab udhar likha hai. Aapko kya karna padega? Ye jo sport ka A, B, C, D, E, F, G, I, H, I, J, wahan tak jo hai, one after the other, you have to complete your journal work from now onwards. समझ में आया मैंने क्या बोला? You can unmute yourself and talk. So what you have to do there in your journal, in your handbook is also known as journal. So in that journal, there is a part B. Part B experiments there. I will show. I will let me see one second. I will see. One second. Yeah, so can you see? Okay, so there you see part A, B, C, D, E, F, J, I tak hai, jo hai, uska jo handbook open karke, wo handbook mein jo experiment, A mein jo hai, B mein jo hai, C mein jo hai, ye sabhi experiments ka ekdom first aapko karna hai, unka diagram complete karna. Kyunki uske liye lab open karke rakhne ka kuch jarurat nahi hai. Now itself, you can start drawing. Now I will go to that journal part. Then I will show you that. You have to draw the drawing part of this A to J. You understood, friends, now what is my work now? What work I am going to do? What is your assignment? Your assignment is that from the sports section, from the B part, you go one after the other, all the experiments. Only imbibition, you don't have rest. All the experiments are there for your examination. Except imbibition. Imbibition is so simple experiment, but they removed that experiment for this year. But rest, all the experiments are there in that. So wherever diagrams are there, all those diagrams, now you are sitting at home 24 hours. So sitting at home, you draw the diagrams there in the space which is given over there. Now we will see, one second, I will show you that also now. Let me see whether it is given or not. Not there. It is not coming there on your screen. Okay, let me see that whether I can do it or not now itself. Now screen share. Yes, B part. I'm going to share now. Now you see it is coming there on your screen. Okay. No, you are not buying any journal as on today. Government has given clear instruction that the textbook they published, Bal Bharati, that not the textbook, the journal which they published, that we have to use. I showed that time to you, na? So this is the, and this is the book. Can you see?
Yes. Because,
yeah. So this is the book. This you have to buy, and it is clearly mentioned that this book must be there. Because for people who are making money, they want to money, means they want to make money. That means money oriented people, they will ask you to buy the book because they will get commission for that. Now you just see here, it is clearly written there. I don't know whether you are able to read it or not. Now it is clearly written over here. What is written there? Practical notebook published by Bal Bharati. That bracket mein likha hai, certified journal. For that you get 3 marks. And moreover, you are not going to buy the book now, and you cannot buy. So the practical handbook which I showed, that you buy that one, and after that you go to this experiment section. Now you see this is experiment number part B, demonstrative experiments. Look at here. Okay, it is clearly given over there. Highlight. Yeah, it is clearly written here, demonstration experiment, B part experiment, right? In this experiment, you see, this is the first experiment. So what you have to do there, you just go to each and every page like this, and wherever you are supposed to draw the diagram. Now you see here, I think the to draw the diagram, the provision is done. Let me see with my book and then I will tell you. Page number 69. Yeah, there already diagram is there. So whatever diagram you are seeing over here on my screen now, so that is same. So no need to draw that diagram, but because already there, if any labeling is there, that you do there. So any such work you can do now itself. Okay. And similarly, any fill in the blanks or something like that, that nothing is there here in the first experiment. Now you see here, you can define transpiration. You can write it or not, friends, transpiration. You can write by checking your textbook itself. You can write what is the definition of transpiration. You can write what is stomata. You can write endless different types of transpiration. Okay, so you just go through your textbook and see if you can, if you are able to write, you write. Otherwise, you first complete the diagrams only. Now you see, these are the multiple choice questions. Everything you can read and understand. Okay, because here the signature you have to get here only. For every experiment, you have to get signature on this book itself. Then, next experiment, you look at their paper chromatography. I can show you this picture when our lab is open, or if it's not so, then I can show you the picture over here. Whatever you can fill, you fill. Try to fill, but right now I am saying complete the drawing part. So, ये अभी तक मैंने जो experiment दिखाया उधर किधर भी drawing नहीं है. इधर किधर भी ड्राइंग नहीं है, राइटिंग पार्ट ओनली है. अभी इधर डेट वगैरह कुछ डालने का नहीं है, वो ऐसा रख दो, डेट बाद में हम लोग डाल देंगे. wherever diagrams are required to draw, here diagrams are required. Look at, can you draw this diagram? You need my help over there in your lab for drawing this diagram. Your collar must be open for drawing this diagram. Your lab must be open for drawing this diagram. Yes, friends, you just tell me. You can do not drawing there in the there at the home itself right now.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So wherever such diagrams are there, you complete that work. Okay. Even they are asking that photograph also you can stick, but from where you get photograph now? But you better you draw it. Okay. And we are using pen only for writing, but not now. Don't write. Don't start writing now. Writing बाद में मैं बोल देता हूँ आपको. खाली drawings कहाँ कहाँ diagrams है वो draw करो. Only complete diagrams now. Okay, here diagrams are there. Now look at here sketch speaker. देख anatropous ovule का है. अब topic already हमने किया है. Okay, you can draw diagram clearly now. क्वेश्चन आंसर हम लोग बाद में डिस्कस करके लिखेंगे. मैं अगर रीओपनिंग के लिए लेट होता तो हम लोग इधर डिस्कस करेंगे. देन यू कैन राइट. ओके, सो हियर ड्रॉ द डायग्राम ऑफ एनाट्रोपस ओव्यूल. क्लियर? सो टू डायग्राम्स वी हैव सीन सो फार. नाउ द थर्ड वन हियर यू कैन ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. ओके, here one full page is there, page number 90. There you can draw the diagram, complete that work. Page number 91, sketch diagram, there also it is given, 91. So wahan idhar ka diagram karo, and after that mitosis meiosis ka idhar diagram draw kar sakta hai. Abhi stages of meiosis 1 and 2, so draw the diagram over here, and two pages are there, draw the diagram here. Okay, getting me, friends? You are getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. So only diagrams, sir. Don't start writing anything there in your pen. I mean, in your book. Only drawing and any parts that you label with the pencil. Okay. Again, diagrams. Just आगे जाइए, आगे जाके देखो किधर diagram आता है. यह diagram नहीं है. Good. इधर diagram नहीं है. डायग्राम नहीं है. सॉरी, देयर इज नो डायग्राम ओवर हियर. ओके, या हियर डायग्राम देयर. ओके, सो हियर डायग्राम इज देयर. दैट इज दिस इज कॉजिंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स का एरिया है, वहां है. एंड after that here diagrams are there. Okay, here diagrams, is it diagram? Yes, here diagrams there. Okay, no need to write the function now, you just keep that, draw the diagram and keep as it is. And after that I think only this much. Okay, so diagram part we are completing now. How much time you need to draw these diagrams? Very few diagrams are there. How much time? You tell me the time. You just tell me how much time you need. 1 week time. Everybody agree? Okay. So 1 week means today it is 8. So next week by 15 or 16 we will review it. Practical part we will review next week by 15 or 16. So you have one more responsibility. Those who are absent here in the class section now, you know that who are the people, who are your friends, you just tell them also. Okay, you just tell them also to start completing their journal work. Okay, by if they don't have the journal, and if it is bought, and then they have to complete this work. And my batches, I'm repeating from A session, A division, one batch is there. Their first batch is there. A2 batch is there. I don't know that whether how many batches there, A2, A3, or A2 batches with me. Means those who are, when you are then 11th standard, those who are with me, they are with me there in 12th standard also. Okay, A2 is there, C2 is there, and B2 is there. Am I right, friends? No, B1 is there, right? B1.
Yes, sir.
B1, A2, A3. But no need to see that only B1 will do, B2 will not do. No, no. You do. Everybody, let everybody do it. Whether it is B1, B2, B3, C3, A3, whoever it is, let them do it. You just inform everyone that to start completing the general work simultaneously, because we won't get time later. Because all these things you can do easily at home right now, since you are sitting at home. Okay? So you are okay with these instructions now? So you will take the responsibility to inform other students also, because I don't have any contact with the other students, other classrooms, okay, and other WhatsApp group. So those who are there in biology WhatsApp group, I am in communication with them, or I can communicate to them. So you please inform everyone, okay, irrespective of the batches A, B, and C, all three divisions, you please inform and ask them to start writing start completing the general work. Okay, so I hope that you understood today's session. Okay, everything is clear to you. Now I'm going to stop this one, and tomorrow morning again we will meet. Till then, take care, enjoy yourself, have a nice day. Bye bye.